please. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night.
And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid.
And the angel said unto them, fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people.
For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord.
And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger.
And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying,
glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men.
And that's what Christmas is all about.
Jesus. sight. The shepherds are a-trembling at what he has to say. Rejoice, for a Savior was born, Emmanuel, Christ the Lord, and a mighty host of angels joined in to proclaim.
One of my special Christmas memories all began on December the 24th, 1973. We made our way to Baylor Hospital, and I was immediately escorted into the labor room. And the room filled up with all of the hospital staff, and I got ready to prepare for this delivery. And eventually all the staff left and the room became really quiet, and I realized there's Christmas music playing. And I settled in for this wait for this baby, and I began to concentrate on the Christmas music and the Christmas carols. And I just started to remember about Mary. I thought about her, and I thought about another mother, a baby, and I was wondering what she was thinking and what she was going through, because I was scared and I was new at this and I didn't know what was going on, and I kept thinking about her environment. And so eventually the time passed, and they came in and they said, we're going to take you to the delivery room. And I went, yay. And we went into the delivery room, and again, there were wonderful people there to help you. And so as the time passed again, this nurse came over to me and she said, you have a little girl. And I was so excited because it was exactly what I wanted. And I wasn't thinking about it exactly at that time, but I was thinking, oh boy, shopping. But Kimberly was born at 3:39 a.m. December the 25th, and she weighed 7 pounds, 9 ounces. And later, they let me go and get in the room, and when they brought her in and they laid her in my arms, I knew this was a very special gift, and this was the best Christmas that I had ever had.
Today the glory. The wind. was the oldest child, so, I was the oldest out of four. I'm 3 years older than my oldest, my next. So I remember having to be the big kid and look out for the kids and anticipating Christmas again. So far as growing up, I remember 1 year I wanted a guitar. Didn't think I was gonna get that guitar. Times weren't the best of all the time. You know, sometimes my parents were in good position, maybe sometimes they weren't, and, you know, not knowing if Santa Claus was gonna come, but he always did. And so I remember wanting that guitar, and I was able to get that guitar. Can't play it, but I did get it, so. I can think of many Christmases as my kids were growing up. This is Christmas as a firefighter, at least in my eyes. You're at work either on Christmas Eve or Christmas Day. And, you know, Christmas for the children is a buildup. You know, they're anticipating, you know, their gifts, opening their gifts. Well, daddy's at work, you know. And so if I'm working Christmas Eve, that means I work the 24th. I don't get home until 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock, the 25th. So my memories are them calling me, Daddy, when are you going to come home? When are you going to come home? And what time will you be there? And then when I get there, they're waiting, anticipating on me getting there so they could begin their Christmas, opening their gifts. And so that's one of my memories. And then if I can put a public safety spin on it, it would be that we all have a safe Christmas, that we can have a day where no fire trucks are running, no police calls, only cheer. And a good time and a safe time for the citizens of Fort Worth. That would be my wish. The reason for Christmas is, you know, Jesus and his birth. And so, you know, Christmas is a time to remember the reason for the season, and that's Jesus Christ.
Singing, ding dong. Jesus Christ is born. The shepherds all were watching for their sheep at night, when a shining star shone from heaven and they followed that holy light.
You were able to vote for your favorite carol, and so here are the top three that you voted for, and we'll sing those. Why don't we stand together as we sing? Hark the Herald Angels Sing.
Oh, Oh, you know, there are just so many Christmas memories in Fort Worth. When I was a kid, the big Christmas memory was Santa Claus was at Mrs. Baird's Bakery, which was on the West Freeway. And everybody, you really didn't go see Santa Claus anywhere else. That was a big deal to see Santa Claus, stood in line. And I can remember the year I was 5 or 6 was the first outbreak, a polio outbreak. And my parents drove us down and let us look at Santa Claus, but they wouldn't let us get out and stand in line. And I can remember crying and being very upset because that was also the year they started the polio vaccines, but it was before everybody really got them. Yeah, there are just lots of memories. One of my fondest memories is of my children. We lived on a very quiet street in the TCU area, and my best friend lived across the street with her husband and her kids. And the kids would all get up real early and everybody would open their gifts and they'd all dash out down the street. And Sherlyn, Flip, and Tom and I'd sit on the sidewalk on Christmas morning and watch them ride their bicycles and Hot Wheels and scooters up and down the street. And the girls had their baby dolls and they'd perch them in the baskets on their bike. And the four of us would just sit and watch them. So it's a great place. The weather usually is just really fabulous. And it doesn't snow much around here. And about 5 years ago, we went always go to church on Christmas Eve. That's our big tradition, is everybody goes to church together on Christmas Eve. And it snowed on Christmas Eve, and that was really fun. My grandsons were 3 and 2, and they just couldn't believe it was snowing on Christmas Eve. You know, my main wish for Fort Worth is that we would continue to have a city of compassionate people who care about each other, who are engaged in the city. That truly is the strength of this city. We're the 16th largest city in the nation, but we have that wonderful small town feel because people care about each other and they're willing to share and to help those who don't have the resources, but those who do have mega resources are willing to help the rest of the community. And I'd love to see that continue on through the next 2 or 3 generations.
Let it be Christmas everywhere, in the hearts of all people, both near and afar. Christmas everywhere, feel the love of the season wherever you are, on the small country road lined with green mistletoe, big city streets where 1,000 lights glow. Let it be Christmas everywhere, let heavenly music fill the air, let every heart sing, let every bell ring the story of hope and joy and peace. And let it be Christmas everywhere, let heavenly music fill the air, let anger and fear and hate disappear, let there be love that lasts through the year. And let it be Christmas, Christmas everywhere. Christmas everywhere, with the gold and the silver, the green and the red. Christmas everywhere, in the smiles of all children asleep in their bed, in the eyes of young babies that first born in snow, elderly's memories that never grow old. Let it be Christmas everywhere, let heavenly music fill the air, let every heart sing, let every bell ring the story of hope and joy and peace. And let it be Christmas everywhere, let heavenly music fill the air, let anger and fear and hate disappear, let there be love that lasts through the year. And let it be Christmas, Christmas everywhere. Let it be Christmas everywhere, in the songs that we sing and the gifts that we bring. Christmas everywhere, in what this day means and what we believe, from the sandy white beaches where blue water rolls,
covered mountains with valleys below.
My life was kind of in limbo. I was a pretending Christian, okay, all my life. I was active in churches. I was a deacon in a church. My two boys I raised in the church, and I just filled in all the blanks, and I was a pretending Christian. And then I met Betsy, and we were looking for a church to begin our lives together. And we had a friend that mentioned a singing Christmas tree. I thought, a singing Christmas tree? You gotta be kidding me. Anyway, we went, and it was fantastic. I was so impressed. I told Betsy, I said, hey, I've got to be a part of that. And sure enough, I did. And that was 17, 18 years ago, and I'm still singing in a choir. And this was another turning point in my life. I saw the light. I saw the light. All these years I pretended to be a Christian, and finally, by studying the Word, I got to know Jesus, not about Jesus.
Settled for lies, I had been blinded. I couldn't see till a star in Bethlehem sky opened my eyes. Seen the light shining in the darkness, bursting through the shadows, delivering the dawn. I have seen the baby who could believe
the one. I can't believe it. I know it's true.
Testimony that you just heard a moment ago with Jerry, one of the members of our choir and singing in the tree tonight, he made an interesting statement. He said, there was a time in my life where I knew about Jesus, but I didn't know Jesus. You see, I think everybody in the room knows about Jesus. It's at this time of year all over the world. In over 1,000 languages, people stop to celebrate the birth of one baby. Now that's pretty phenomenal. We've heard the story of Jesus, but the story of Jesus is a story that brings with it a promise that we can know not just about him, but know him. You see, the Bible says that we are sinners separated from God. All of us have sinned. In fact, the scripture says all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Now that's pretty simple, isn't it? All means all. And that's all means, right? All of us have sinned. And the Bible says the wages of sin is death. The reason that we're all going to die one day is because we're sinners separated from God. And we're separated from God with no hope, no guarantee of tomorrow. because of the sin that is a part of our life and the punishment that comes with it. But the story of Christmas is that God loves us so much that he wants to have a relationship with us. He wants us to know him personally. And so he came to earth and did for us what we could not do ourselves. We could never be good enough to earn our way into God's presence. He is a holy, righteous God. We've already blown it. We're sinners. But Jesus came to earth, born different. That's why we celebrate his birth. Born of a virgin. He did not inherit a sin nature like we did when we were born. And he lived a sinless life, so he didn't have to suffer the consequences for sin like we do. And he died on a cross to pay the penalty for your sin and mine, so that if we place our trust in him, we can have everlasting life. And that's why we celebrate Christmas. It is God's gift of eternal life to us, so that we can know God personally. We can experience his love and his grace. And all we have to do to embrace the gift that God has for us is to accept it. Like any gift that is given at Christmas time, we have to accept it. And God offers it, and he says, if you want this gift, just admit you're a sinner and know that you can't save yourself, and ask me to forgive you of your sin. Believe in me. Ask me to come into your life. And if we do that, God will come into our life and we can have eternal life. And that's what we want to invite you to do this season of the year, to come to a place where you can know God personally through faith in Christ. And so I'm going to pray for you. And if you, maybe you're here and you've thought about that for a long time, you've kind of been contemplating the idea of becoming a Christian or a Christ follower, and you'd like to do that, we would invite you to just simply pray a prayer. And you can do that even as I pray with you. Dear God, there are many in this room who have never accepted the gift of eternal life that you offer. And today they can receive that gift by just simply saying, God, I know I'm a sinner. I get that. I ask you to forgive me of my sin. Come into my life. Jesus, I believe you came to earth. You are God in the flesh. You came to earth and lived a sinless life, and you died to pay the penalty for my sin. And so I ask you to forgive me of my sin. Come into my life. I give you my life. And I thank you for the eternal life that I receive from you. In Jesus' name, amen. And if you prayed a prayer like that, God honors our request and our prayer, and we can have eternal life. Now, there might be that some of you are here today and you're not from a Christian background. You're not really sure what Christians believe. You're kind of looking over the fence, and you've heard the story, and some of this makes sense to you. Some of it is intriguing. And if you would like to know more about what the Bible teaches and how you can know God personally and what the Bible says about you, we would love the opportunity to visit with you. And we're not going to put you on the spot. We'll just try to answer the questions you have and dialogue with you about what it means to have a relationship with God. In the handout that you received when you came in, there's a place at the very bottom where you can check several boxes. If you prayed with me a moment ago, you can check that box. If you would like to know more about what it means to be a Christ follower, you can check that box. We'll get in touch with you, and we're not going to bombard you with all kinds of emails and information, but we will reach out to you and give you an opportunity to ask those questions, and we can dialogue together. Now, we're going to give you an opportunity every year. As a part of our coming together, we think that it's neat for us to collectively give back. And every year we receive an offering, and none of that money goes to us. We take that offering and we designate different areas of ministry that we can be a part of, and we can join together and make an impact in our world. We've sent it around the globe. We've used it here in Fort Worth. And this year, as we were praying about what we could give and how we could make an impact, several months ago, before all of the dialogue about refugees and all that kind of stuff, we have such an opportunity to reach out to those that are new to our country, and we do that on a regular basis. And there are many of those who are refugees here in Fort Worth that don't have transportation to and from work. And a bicycle makes all the difference in the world for them. And so we thought, you know, what if we were to buy bicycles and provide that for some of our adult refugees refugees so that they can get back and forth to work. And about $150 will buy a bicycle, a helmet, a lock, and we'll put them in business. And we want to give you an opportunity to be a part of that. If you'd like to give toward that, please, we welcome that. If not, we certainly understand this is our gift to you as well. But we're going to receive our offering, and as we receive the offering, if you want to check one of those boxes so that we can get in touch with you, drop that in that offering bucket when it comes by, and let that be your contribution to us today. So let's just receive our offering and have that opportunity to participate together with others.
Righteousness, he humbled himself and carried our cross. Love so amazing, it was love so amazing. Jesus Messiah, name above all. Sinners, the ransom from heaven.
told you about how you can have a relationship with God, and you saw the testimonies of others who have come from a place where they know about Jesus to the place where they know Him and the difference it made in their life. And we pray that you'll come to know Him too. We're so glad that you've come. And from all of us at Southcliff Church, we say to you, Merry Christmas and good night.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish